Right now, lawmakers giving unanimous approval to a proposal that gives police access to your cell phone records without a court order. 7 News reporter Molly Hendrickson just stepping out of the debate at the Capitol. Molly, this pits emergency against privacy.
Yeah, and some are saying that it even infringes on their Fourth Amendment rights. Now, basically, your cell phone is always tracking you, the GPS sending pings back to cell phone towers. Now, if this bill ends up passing and becoming law, police would no longer need a warrant to get that information from cell phone companies if they had probable cause and if they believed your life is in danger. Finding the missing is often a race against time, but only a parent knows the crushing pain left when that time runs out.
As you look and see where the system failed your daughter, and then you find a way to fix it.
For Greg Smith, that fail came in 2007. His daughter Kelsey was abducted and murdered. It took Verizon 4 days to turn her cell phone records over to police.
Once those records were delivered to the police, they found my daughter's body in 45 minutes.
It's the reason he's testifying for House Bill 1308. If passed, police with probable cause would only need to show waiting on a warrant could put the victim's life at risk. So far, 9 states have such a law.
If you don't have access to that person within 24 to 48 hours, chances are you're not going to recover him alive.
Tell that to Denise Mays of the ACLU.
Even in rural communities, judges are known to work 24/7, especially in these sort of situations.
She says the bill goes too far, jeopardizing privacy in the name of safety.
And start sort of fishing for phone records among a variety of individuals, I think you've run some problems into the Fourth Amendment.
Mays says checks and balances are necessary. Going through a judge ensures them.
Expediency is not a reason to trample my privacy rights nor yours.
And from here, the bill moves to the floor. Reporting live at the Capitol, Molly Hendrickson, 7 News.